Okay, so let's look at another great places that you can generate textures to your 3D game assets or a 3D mesh or 3D model that you want to apply any textures to it. So let's get started. So here, this is called Meshy.ai. So here in Meshy.ai, you can see that AI generated 3D game assets, or you can generate textures for your 3D model or 3D mesh. So you can see some examples right here. This is some example that they have the untextured mesh, and then you can see the prompt applied to it, Adly tone giant, Adly yellow, and you can see here in three simple steps you can be able to generate textures to your 3D mesh. Here, join the Discord and go to newbies channel and then receive the texture model. So you can see here it says get started. To get started, once you click, it gets you to the Discord. So make sure to have an account with Discord so you can be able to generate textures to your mesh. So let's get over to Discord now. Here you can see this is the Meshy Discord server here, and here's some information where you can get started like we just looked at earlier. Go to any newbies channel, type in, but make sure to know that the currently, they supported FBX, OBJ, STL, GLTF, and GLB models with UV maps. So it's very important that you UV unwrap your mesh before you bring it in here. So to get started, to upload one of the model, we're gonna do our first modeling in Blender. So here I'm using Blender 3.5. So let's just model a little ceramic pot that we're gonna apply the ceramic texture to it. Okay, so here's my screencast key right here. So you can check the shortcut keys and things like that that I'm using to model this little flower pot. So first let's select the cube and hit X to delete that, and then Shift A to add a new mesh, and this time we're gonna add in a cycle. So hit Tab to go into edit mode, and then hit E to extrude up, and then Z or Z depending on where you are to extrude this one up like this. Hold it there, and then S to scale it out, and then E again, and Z or Z to extrude up. Hit E again to extrude up, and then S to scale it in, and then E, S, and scale it a little bit in like that. Now let's scroll in with the middle mouse button to go into the center here, and then you can do a box select or something like that, and select the bottom here, and hit F to add the face in there, and hit E and S to extrude in like that. Okay, so that's all we need to do, and now we can do some final touching on it. So just hit the Control or Command, and just scale this up like this, and we do the same, Control, Command, and R. Now let's select that. Let's go to the Rens icon here, the modifier properties here, and then add a modifier. So we want to solidify this, so we can make it a little bit thicker. Okay, so using the thickness here, you can just slide it up to make it more a little bit thicker. And then let's add a subdivision surface modifier to make it more smooth. So let's just add, I think the level of viewport, the render is 2. Let's put the render to 3 and the level of viewport to 3. So now we have that. You can do a right click and smooth it up. And now let's enable the material properties here by just adding something like that. Our next thing is to go to UV editing here and select all of them, and then hit U and UV smart, smart UV project. So just select that, so you can see we just unwrap everything from here. Okay, so that's all we need to do, and we go to file and export. So you can see if you go back to the Discord server, you can see they supported FBX, OBJ, STL, and all these other file here. So let's go back to Blender, and we want to go to file and export as WAVE or STL FBX here. So let's use FBX. Let's select that and go to some place that we can store this in. And let's just put it as a flower pot, and then let's export that. So we're done exporting and also done with Blender for now. So let's just close Blender. Okay, so we are back here now. Time to apply the texture to our little flower pot. So let's go to newbie. So here in the newbie, you can see these are some of my model that I've already uploaded here. So what we can do in the message section here, all you have to do is add a pod slash and then you select the skin. And once you select the skin, you need to upload your model here. So let's click here and go to where we have the model. Okay, so here's our FBX file. Let's click select that and open it. And here it is in now. And now let's type in our prompt. Okay, so I just put in a blue ceramic pot. Let's see if it comes out with that. Highly detailed textures, daisy flowers engraved on it, and realistic texture. So this is a little prompt that I just type in. And here you can see the public. Once you click this, what it means is if you click true, it means it's gonna it will display here on the public so others can also see it. But if you select false, then it's gonna be only you. And once we have that, that's all we need to do, and hit enter and wait for your textures to be applied to your mesh. Okay, as you can see now, our little texturing the our flower pot is done, and it's nicely done. That you can see it says a blue ceramic, but it doesn't give blue ceramic, but it gives us the daisy flower. That's really nice. So you can see here the texture being applied to our 3D model here. Okay, so you can download this little video clip here. So you can download that as your reference. And also you can download the model with the texture here. Okay, so here's the zip file which containing our 3D model being textured. So just unzip that, and now we can bring this back into Blender. So we are again in Blender 3.5. So let's just delete this first of all, then we enable my screencast key. Okay, so we're in Blender now. Let's delete the cube there, and then go to file and import the file. So the Meshy.ai generated the texture to the mesh. And then the download model is a file with a GLB. So let's select the GLB file. I'll go to the location where we have that. And let's select our model and import it in. So here's our model. And now let's go to viewport. And you can see here's the model here. So it's very new. It does a pretty good work, but you can see some of the things here which are not needed, but it's okay. But for now, let's just leave it for this purpose. Let's go to the layout and add the camera. So hit 0 on your numpad to add the camera, and then let's hit N to pull out this panel, and let's go to view, and then lock the camera to the view, and I come here to the output settings, and I want to change this to 1080 as well, like the X and Y value. Now what I need to do now, I already locked the camera, so hit N to hide this panel, and then simply zoom in to bring your model. So you can see here it's still low resolution, so you can use Blender or you can later use any AI software to upscale it up. If you want to add any background, you can do that, but for now let's just render it. So first go to the render option here. I just want to put the render here to 100, and then change the render engine to cycle, and I want to change this to 30 seconds, and the max sample to 200. Okay, so before we render this, let's see if the lighting is okay. So let's go in here, and you can see the lighting is here. Now you can either add light or you can use the HDRI to light up your scene. From here, we can click here, environmental texture, and then let's go in here and go to where we have our texture. Okay, so it helps to light up our scene here, and what we need to do if we want to light up the inside of this flower pot here, we can just add the light in. You can see it's lighting up a little bit, but we can add a new one. So shift plus A and go to light, and then you can add point light, and you can see it's lighting up inside there. Okay, so that's all we need to do, and we were not going to render with this HDRI background here. So what we need to do, go back again to the render properties here, go to film, and then transparent, make sure to enable this to remove that, and now let's render it. Okay, so that's all for this video. Thank you again for watching, and that's a big help for 3D artists. Now it doesn't take you away from your modeling, but it only apply the texture, so in a way it's speeding up your workflow. Thank you for watching, and if you have not subscribed to our channel, please do that, and see you back again in another video.